Well, hello everybody. This is John, once again from one side of a two-car garage in central Mississippi. Today is January the 1st. It's almost lunch. My wife has got the traditional southern dinner cooking in there. We've got turnip greens and cabbage and cornbread and ham and black-eyed peas. And I'm out here in the one side of this garage working on another project. If you've never seen any of my other videos, or perhaps this is the first time because you saw this related to ham radio, just a little background, I have managed to put together a small machine shop, a woodworking shop, and just a tinker shop over in one side of this garage. It's a little chilly outside, so I'm out here today. I've got my coffee with me, and today's project is going to be in honor of my uncle, Ed Robertson, who was called sign W5CYF, who I've applied to take that call sign, and probably by the time that you are viewing this video, that will be my call sign. I'm currently KF5DMI out of Brandon, Mississippi, and I've applied, and I think probably either the 5th or the 6th of January, I'll be known as W5CYF. So, this is in honor of my uncle, who had two things. He has been dead for about 10 years, and he had two things that he prided himself on, among others. But the two things when it came to ham radio was he wanted one of the best sounding signals, and he really strived on building a lot of the things himself. He was the old school type of ham who homebrewed lots of things. And when he homebrewed, his goal was to get as high quality as he could without spending a great deal of money. Today, I'm going to do a project that probably he would have approved, and I'm going to build an antenna switch that if you were to buy would be at minimum of $25 for an MFJ, perhaps $30 for that, for as much as you want to spend. I know some people are going to say, well, this thing's not going to work, or the parts aren't just exactly right, but this would have been something that he would have used, and I will go ahead and suggest that many hams used at one time as they worked strictly out of their scrap box. I'm going to build this today for less than $3, an antenna switch, or perhaps less than $5. So let's go ahead and get started with a ham amateur radio antenna switch that will switch two antennas to one radio or two radios to one antenna. So get my coffee, drink another sip, and I'll see you back at the workbench. Okay, we'll take a look at some of the things that we'll be using, some tools that you'll need today. Of course, you'll need some pliers, and we're going to take a look at some of these little nibblers. You'll need those perhaps. Then I've got some needle nose pliers that are bent. Just any needle nose pliers will work. We're going to build the antenna today, our antenna switch today, and put it together with pop rivets. And of course, you'll need a pop rivet gun. You can also use a number 6 machine screws. It'll be just as well. I just prefer the pop rivets. They're just a lot quicker. And on these projects right here where there's not a lot involved in it, I can either grind the pop rivet out if I need to, or just go ahead. Now, over here is the heart of the antenna switch. And believe it or not, we're going to be using today a metal outlet box. It's metal because this will have to ground all of our antenna connectors. And the plate is just a plate. This came out of Lowe's. This was less than $2. Both of those pieces totaled, I think, $1.45, $1.46. The SO239 connectors, I buy these off eBay. They're about $1 a piece if you buy them in bulk, and that includes the shipping on those. They're pretty fair. They're not the very best in the world, but I have a rather small station here, so I'm not a big gun. I'm just a little bitty gun in a whole big field of folks out through there. So these seem to work very well, and I buy them off eBay. I think they're like $1 a piece. You'll need some number 14 copper wire. This is just straight copper wire. You can buy this at Lowe's, and I stripped the insulation off. For the switch, we're going to be building this with a double pole, double throw switch out of Radio Shack. The part number of this, you probably aren't going to be able to see that, so I'll just put it back down and read it. The part number is 275-0403. It's a package of two, and they sell for $2.99. So I suppose I'll probably have about $6 in this switch using the arithmetic. And then you're going to need the obligatory soldering gun. This is a pretty heavy little soldering gun I use, so I can get in and get out pretty quickly when I'm soldering the SO239 switches. So there you have it. That's all you need.